So the title of the presentation is Strategy Synthesis for Autonomous Driving in a Moving Block Railway System with Upal Stratego. I am Davide Basile, and this is a joint work with Maurice Terbeck. We are from ISTCNR Pisa, and Axel Legay from Université Catholique de Louvain. So as the title of the presentation displays, the goal of this paper is to synthesize strategies for driving autonomously a train in a moving block railway system, and we use the Upal Stratego to do this. So this is the summary of the presentation. I will start by reviewing the project in which this paper is placed. It is a Horizon 2020 European project. Then I will describe the case study that we have analyzed, and I will describe the model and the analysis that we have performed, and I will draw a conclusion and future work. So in this background, we discuss about the Shift to Rail initiative. It's a European initiative and is a joint undertaking between the European Commission and the main railway stakeholders. And the goal is to move European railway industry for increasing its competitiveness. And for doing that, there are several technological challenges. For example, the use of satellite-based train positioning, the use of moving block distancing instead of fixed block. I will say more about this later. And autonomous driving, which is one of the goals of this paper. So our lab has been involved in the past in several projects on the usage of formal methods in railway system. AstRail is a project that has just finished a few months ago, and it was about selecting what are the best formal methods to be used in a railway system. And then there is an ongoing project that has started this year, which is ForSecurail, and the goal of this project is to perform a cost and benefit analysis on the usage of formal methods from the point of view of the infrastructure managers. So this is just a brief summary of the context in which this work is placed. So there is a long-standing history of adoption of formal methods in railways, mainly for verifying that interlocking tables are safe. And this is because there are in the railway field there are stringent safety requirements, and thus formal methods are highly recommended for applications that have a high safety critical level. However, mainly formal methods techniques that are adopted are model checking and theorem proving. These techniques are predominant. One example is the B method, which provides ProB as a model checker and Atelier B as a theorem prover. And we argue that, to the best of our knowledge, applications of controller synthesis techniques are largely lacking. So in this paper, we want to adopt a controller synthesis technique to synthesize an optimal strategy for driving an autonomous train. So what is controller synthesis? The goal of controller synthesis is, given a model and a property to verify, the goal is to refine such model, such specification, such that the refined specification satisfies the given requirement. And for doing that, we have background in our laboratory. We have developed in the past formalisms and tools for performing controller synthesis. However, here we wanted to try a mature tool that is Upal Stratego, that is a recent tool for performing both strategy synthesis and optimization. So about Upal Stratego, Upal Stratego is the most recent tool of the Upal suite developed by Uppsala and Aalborg University. It combines both Upal TIGA for strategy synthesis and Upal Statistical Model Checker for performing statistical model checking. As this picture depicts here, by the way, this picture is taken from this site. In Upal Stratego, the models are the formalism is stochastic price time game. The idea is that these models can be abstracted to time game, and in time game we can perform a synthesis using Upal TIGA to compute a strategy. the strategy can be model checked, or can be paired with a stochastic priced game. In this way, we can learn an optimized strategy, and we can perform statistical model checking on such optimized strategy. So I'm going very quickly, I have a few time. This is the case study that we wanted to model with Stratego. It's taken from the AstRail project. It's a moving block system. So the idea is that in railways, we have fixed blocks that are sectors, portions of the railway track where only one train can be placed. In moving blocks, instead, we have an envelope around the train, and this envelope follows the train, and thus we increase the capacity of the railway network. This is something that is being studied in these projects. Also, we have autonomous positioning with the satellites. And this is the case study where we have a train that is composed of a location unit and an onboard unit. Basically, the train receives the location from the location unit, communicates the location unit to the radio block center, and the radio block center replies with a movement authority that is the headway that the train is allowed to proceed. And these communications are performed frequently. We model the scenario in UPAL Stratego. These are the various automata that are composing the system. We have an onboard unit, a location unit, and RBC. In particular, the onboard unit is composed of different automata. We have an automata that is in charge of generating requests for new location to send to the location unit. Location unit receives this request and replies with new positions. Then we have a component, send location to RBC, that basically receives the position from the location unit and sends it to the radio block center, and receives the movement authority back from the RBC. Here we have the control to check if the position of the train has exceeded its movement authority. That I recall is the space that the train is allowed to proceed. So in this case, if the movement authority is exceeded, we have a failure. Then we have a radio block center that is the component that basically receives the request of movement authority and replies with the movement authority. And then it waits for an acknowledgement and sends the movement authority until the acknowledgement is received. Finally, we have a component for receiving the movement authority and sends the acknowledgement. This is the last component on the onboard unit. In this paper, we are more interested in the automatic train operation component of the train that models the behavior of the train. I give more details of this component here. So in all the previous components, all transitions cannot be controlled by the strategy that we want to synthesize. While this is the case for this automaton, we have in particular only one transition that is controllable and can be the strategy basically decide which value to take in this transition. This is the only thing that the strategy can do. In particular, we see that we have two possibility of having speed of the train that are 0 and 1. So the train is either allowed to proceed to the next space unit or not, or it can remain in the same place. And this, of course, depends on the movement authority. And then we have that when the location of the train reaches a particular position, then the train has arrived and the simulation stops. Then we have also failure states and other communications parameter. We see that when the train moves, it also updates its location, its headway, and this is the way in which the location is simulated in this model. And there is, of course, a check about the movement authority here. So each time a new movement authority, the headway is initialized to the movement authority. All the details of these models are available in this link, and there are more details in the paper, of course. So we move to the analysis that we have performed on this model. The setup of the parameters for this case was that the movement authority was set to 5 units. And then in the end, we see that we tried a sensitivity analysis with other parameters for the movement authority. So at the beginning of the verification, we wanted to see if our model is safe or not. That is the failure if it's ever reached at all, because if it would never be reached, that would be no problem. Indeed, this property is not satisfied. This is done by standard model checking, of course. And this is because allowing the train to move non-deterministically, there is the possibility that a failure is performed in case the train is too fast if compared to its movement authority that is received by the train. By the way, all communications here are stochastic. There are stochastic delays in the communications between the various components. After that, we wanted to estimate the probability of reaching such a failure. Before doing that, we wanted to estimate the arrival time of the train in average. For doing that, we performed this statistical model checking analysis of this formula, phi 1. We basically compute the average on 700 time units of using 10,000 simulation. The average maximum value of train of timer. Timer is an hybrid clock that is used, that is basically a clock, a stopwatch that is stopped when the train reaches its destination. And so we can see in this plot, this is the plot of the property, that around 500 time units, more or less, most of the trains have arrived. The average here is 377. And there is a peak in 700 because, of course, in case of failures, the train never reaches this destination. So the timer, the value, the maximum value of the timer will be the bound on this simulation. So this is why. So performing this first analysis, we can say that the other analysis will be performed using 500 as a time bound. The second query, we want to check the probability that the failure is obtained in 500 units. And we have a non-negligible probability of failure. We can see that this is the probability confidence interval for this formula. Here the confidence is 0.995, and this is due to the parameters of the model checker that has been set up for this analysis. And Upal used 33,000 simulations to compute this value. So this is a non-negligible probability of failure. So what to do in this case to amend this model? This is the interesting part. Instead of modeling the logic of the controller to drive the train, we can do this automatically without doing any modeling effort by synthesizing in Upal Stratego a strategy for automatically drive the train in such a way that the movement authority is never exceeded. And this is performed with this command. Once we have computed a strategy, we did 50 simulations on 500 time units of the location of the train using the safe strategy. We can see that the train in all simulations reaches its destination with a certain speed depending on the simulation. The problem is that a safe strategy could leave the train always stuck. So firstly, we wanted to analyze that now the probability of reaching a failure under the safe strategy is zero. The property is satisfied, and this is the property that says that we never reach a failure in that. So indeed, the strategy that we have synthesized is safe. We were talking about reliability, and in particular here the safe strategy is not reliable in the sense that there are traces simulation in which the train does not reach its destination. For example, the train could remain stuck in its initial position. This is a safe strategy. The probability of reaching the target position, however, is high. So at the end, we wanted to optimize our safe strategy in such a way that we reach the terminal position in the minimum time as possible. And for doing that, we use the optimization capability of Upal Stratego. And we can see in these two formulas that phi5, that is the optimized strategy, reaches the destination in less time than phi4, which is the strategy without using the optimized strategy. And this is again the average time in which the average time in which the destination is reached under the optimal strategy. At the end, we wanted to do a sensitivity analysis to check for other values of movement authority if we have best results. The results, these are the properties that we analyzed so far, and however, the results tells us that 5 is the best compromised in this scenario for having minimum arrival time while retaining safety. So, conclusion and future work. This was a first application of autonomous driving optimal strategies synthesis for this particular signaling system using UPAL Stratego. And we have to say that in this case study, we had interactions with the developers team to Uppsala and Aalborg to fix several some issues that we found during the modeling phase. In particular, we noted that for performing the synthesis, we need a full state exploration, and this is a problem when we use industrial science case studies and reduces the benefits of statistical model checking. So, as a future work, we are interested in investigating statistical strategy synthesis possibilities. So to avoid the state space blow up problem, and we want to try, of course, the model with different setup of parameters, and we want to discuss with our industrial partner the potential applications of such technology in our railway projects. And thanks for your attention.